Hello, good morning children. Till now we have learned increase and decrease in demand. Now, next topic we are going to take, that is individual demand and market demand. Do you know children what is called individual demand? Individual demand is the demand of a good. Good means any commodity by an individual consumer or customer, you can say, at a given price at a particular point of time. Say for an example, we are in need of vegetable or fruits nowadays, so that is called our individual demand. Now what do you mean by market demand? The sum total of individual demands of all existing consumers in the market is called market demand at a given price at a particular point of time. I repeat, the sum total of individual demand of all existing consumer in the market is called market demand at a given price at a particular point of time. Next, elasticity of demand. Elasticity of demand is the extent. Extent means to some value or portion area is the extent to which demand responds to changes in any of its determinants. Price elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand is the extent, proportion means part of something whole to which demand changes with a change in price. Its equation is price elasticity of demand percentage, but here you will observe a minus sign. Minus sign means a negative sign. Later on I will explain you why we have to put here negative sign. Percentage change in demand upon percentage change in price. There is an inverse. Inverse means completely opposite relationship between demand and price. Earlier I have explained you that if price fall, then demand rise, and if demand fall, then price rise. So here you can understand that what is the inverse relationship between demand and price. Demand and price of a commodity. Hence, for easy analysis, for observation, negative sign is assigned to it. Price elasticity of demand is expressed as the pure number and is not associated with any unit of measurement. Definition of price elasticity of demand. According to Marshall, price elasticity of demand is the extent of change in demand because of change in its price. Now let's see types or degrees of price elasticity of demand. Perfectly elastic demand. I repeat, perfectly elastic demand. An infinite change in demand for a commodity because of negligible change in its price, that is EP2 infinitive. Perfectly inelastic demand. No change in demand for a commodity due to change in its price by any amount, that is EP is equal to zero. First meaning is that at any cost you are ready to purchase certain commodities, say for an example vegetable, fruits, medicine. Anybody's price is increasing, we do not bother that much. We may reduce the quantity, but the commodities are in demand at any price. Second is that if price is increasing, we are not ready to purchase it. Means we can survive without that particular thing, and that is why it is known as perfectly inelastic demand. No change in demand for a commodity due to change in its price by any amount. That is EP is equal to zero. No effect on commodity when price rises there. Next is unitary elastic demand. Percentage change in demand for a commodity is proportionate to percentage change in its price, that is EP is equal to 1. Next is relatively elastic demand. Percentage change in demand for a commodity is proportionately more than percentage change in its price, that is EP greater than 1. Fifth is relatively inelastic demand, that is percentage change in demand for a commodity to proportionately less than percentage change in its price, that is EP less than 1. Now, income elasticity of demand. The extent means to some volume. The extent of change in demand for a commodity due to change in income of the consumer is called income elasticity of demand. If our income is more than 1 lakh, I can say just for an example, if it is more than 1 lakh, any luxurious things, or you can live a luxurious life as well. But if your father's income is not to that much extent, then I think we have to live a simple life. Somewhere we have to sacrifice also our demand, our wants, many other things. So how it affects to our demand, that you are going to see here. Types, degrees of income elasticity of demand. Positive income elasticity of demand. When demand increases or decreases due to rise or fall in income of the consumer, it is called positive income elasticity of demand. That is, EY is equal to 1, EY greater than 1, EY less than 1. I repeat the definition once again. Positive income elasticity, when demand increases or decreases due to rise or fall in income of the consumer, it is called positive income elasticity of demand. Second one is negative income elasticity of demand. When the rise or fall in income of the consumer, demand for a commodity decreases or increasing, it is called negative income elasticity of demand. I repeat, when the rise or fall in the income of a consumer, demand for a commodity decreases or increasing, it is called negative income elasticity of demand. Inferior goods, griffin goods, have negative income elasticity of demand. Third, zero income elasticity of demand. If demand of the commodity remains unchanged because of various factors, it do not change at all, does not change at all due to the change in the income of consumer, it is called zero income elasticity of demand. For low priced goods like salt, matchsticks, pin, etc. have zero income elasticity of demand. Means your overall income does not affect on the demand of commodity, and that is why it is known as zero income elasticity of demand. Then after, cross price elasticity of demand. When the demand of a concerned commodity changes due to the change in the price of its related commodity, substitute option for that complementary commodity, it is cross price elasticity of demand. Cross price elasticity of demand can be seen like percentage change in demand for commodity X divided by percentage change in price of commodity Y. Method of measuring elasticity of demand, method of proportionate change, EP is equal to proportionate change in demand for commodity X, proportionate change in price of commodity X. Now, EP is equal to minus delta P upon delta EP is equal to delta D upon delta P into P upon D, where delta D is equal to change in demand D1 minus D0, delta P is equal to change in price P1 minus P0, P is equal to original price, that is P0, and D is equal to original demand, that is D0. Total outlay, expenditure means expenses to produce something, total outlay expenditure method, the ratio of total outlay at change price of a commodity to the total outlay at original price of a commodity is known as elasticity of demand. I repeat, the ratio of total outlay at change price of the commodity to the total outlay at original price of a commodity is known as elasticity of demand. EP is equal to total outlay at change price of a commodity upon total outlay at original price of commodity. Geometric method, on the basis of slope of the demand curve, as you have seen in the first chapter, elasticity of demand can be measured. Perfect elasticity, elastic demand. Demand curve is paralleled means equivalent to x-axis, that is EP is equal to infinity. Perfect inelastic demand. Demand curve is parallel to y-axis, that is EP is equal to zero. Unitary elastic demand. Demand curve is straight line from upward left to downward right, that is perfect negative slope, EP is equal to 1. Relative elastic demand, that is relatively slight negative slope of demand curve, that is EP greater than 1. Relative elastic demand, relatively more negative slope of demand curve, that is EP less than 1. I hope that you have understood all the concept of this lesson. Now, I am going to send you some pictures of question answer. In that, tick marks are there. Please write the tick mark question answer in your notebook, fair notebook, and send me on the next Monday. Thank you very much.